Right now, we're not to that point. We are still assessing the structural integrity and trying to shore up places so that we can get in as far as we want.
Ditches that are unaccounted for, what sort of efforts are going on right now?
Right now, it's still a search and rescue mission, so we are still trying to identify those two people. We don't know that those people are actually in the rubble or in the building, so that another one of those people or both of those people could still be, you know, walking around out here somewhere.
Chief.
So first of all, we're trying to identify who those people are and see if we can get in contact with them. We do have, we had, I believe, five people transported to the hospital, one critical. We did have one person that was treated on scene and released.
Brian, so do you have anybody in the building at all?
Right now, the fire is out. We don't have anybody in the building. All the uncollapsed parts of the building have been searched and cleared. So at this point, we're focusing on efforts on just the collapsed part of the building.
Are you like, what does that process look like, getting at the rubble and then removing that or getting to the bottom of it?
Well, it can look a number of different ways. We have to be very intentional about that. Moving one thing can cause a collapse in another spot. So the first thing we need to do is try to identify void spaces where people could be surviving in there, and then try to move the rubble in a way or access those spaces in a way that won't cause any further damage.
Is this something that you train for?
This is something that we do train for. Structural collapse and technical rescues is something that we do train for. We actually have a special crew just for that. We call it the Heavy Rescue Crew, and we are also a member of Task Force 1, which is a state resource that handles these types of emergencies.
Are you moving things brick by brick, or what are you doing?
We are getting to that right now. That's being assessed. It may be where we can move it brick by brick. It may be where we have to get in some heavy equipment to move some bigger slabs or bigger portions of the building.
Can you hear any voices or anything under there?
Right now, I don't have any information that we've heard any voices or anything.
Is there anything you want to say to the public about all this and what they should know?
They should know that we're working hard on trying to identify these last two unaccounted for people. That it may take a while because we have to be very careful about how we do this in order to not cause any further damage, but that we are working on it. We do have a bus set up over on 32nd and West River Road for family members of any people who may have been in the building or may have worked here or whatever to find out where their family members are or what the status of their family members are.
Brian, can you confirm the two that are still unaccounted for, are they staff of the school or part of that contracting firm you spoke about?
That's information I don't have right now. We're still trying to get good identities on those people.
So how do you know that there are two unaccounted for without identities? I'm just curious as to how that process works.
The first thing we do is talk to people who were in the building and ask them if everyone is out or do they know of anybody that would have been in there.
Brian, can you comment on the confidence level that there are people still in there or whether or not they're there?
You know, I'm not confident that they are in there. They may be in there, they may not be in there. I don't know that at this point. Again, the last person that we found was not in there, so our hopes are certainly that the other two are not in there, but we don't know that yet.
We heard some witnesses tell us about civilian efforts to go back in and rescue people. Is that something you encountered?
That's not something that I encountered. Crews may have encountered that. I don't have that information right now. But I would expect that that would happen. That happens a lot on emergencies. People step up and try to help out.
What sort of work was going on that caused the gas main to rupture?
It was work with the gas main, I think with the boiler system specifically.
Brian, were any of the crews working on the gas leak or any of the firefighters injured in this rescue?
Right now, we don't have any firefighter injuries that I'm aware of. I don't know who was involved or who was among the people that were transported to the hospital, if they were school employees or contractors.
All adults?
All adults that I'm aware of.
Do you know roughly how many emergency crew members were working on this particular scene?
No, I don't know. It's a lot.
Could you tell us a little bit about injuries? Did you say one? How many were the injuries?
We transported five to the hospital. One was critical. I don't know the disposition of the other four, other than to know that they are not critical.
The initial report was one fatality. What's the update on that?
We had to back off on that. We had got a radio report that there was one fatality, but it was not confirmed, so we backed off of that. So at this point, we don't have any fatalities. We do have two people who are unaccounted for.
Okay, that's all we have time for right now.